Hey, but we're going to take a few minutes and say a few words, have the mayor come up, and we're going to explain the program to you just a little bit so that everybody will know we get the information out so there won't be any confusion. Amen?
All right.
At this time,
did anybody say the prayer yet?
Nope.
We got to hold up because we must bless this today because we're doing this in the name of the Lord. If you would, stop where you're at and bow your head. Oh, gracious and heavenly Father, God, we come today asking you to have mercy upon this gathering, oh God. Lord, we thank you for the bounty that you've provided for us today. We thank you for placing the men and the women in places who had the heart to do these things for the people today, oh God. We thank you for everything that is going forth and everything that's going to happen from this day on forward, oh God. And we just give you all the glory for this assembly. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, let everybody say,
amen,
amen. Amen. Well, I guess it's officially started. Before I bring the mayor up to have her say a few words for you, we just like to welcome you to the White Springs Food Pantry. She's going to go into details, a little bit more details about it, and how it came about, and what it is we wish to accomplish in the town of White Springs and our surrounding community. We saw that it was a great need, and we heard the cry, and we were willing to help. So, in no further ado, I'm going to bring forth the mayor of White Springs. Give her a hand as she comes forward.
Thank you, Richard, and welcome to everybody.
Have your attention, please.
That's okay. Y'all continue. A couple of years ago, volunteers got together and decided what should we do to help our community here in White Springs. And we started off with education with our after-school and adult ed program. And that led to the summer program and other initiatives for the kids. Then last year, we focused on fuel. That's when the Hope Fuel Bank started. And last year, we provided about 75 tons of firewood to people in our community. At the couple of weeks ago at the Halloween Bash, we were talking with Lieutenant Lodgerton and decided what we needed to focus on next was the Hope Food Bank. And so this is one of many initiatives to help our community so that we can help ourselves. And when you're working at either at school or at the job, if you haven't had a good meal, we all know that impedes our progress. So we want to feed the mind, the soul, and of course our bodies. So we want to thank Mr. David Hutcherson, otherwise known as Jumba, with this wonderful barbecue. So let's give him a hand if you can. And I want to thank Richard Marshall, who is our food bank director. When we, yay, let's hear it for Richard. Richard had this dream, I guess over the past year or so, that knowing the needs of the community, wanted to start the food bank. And of course, I was looking for who's that person to do this, and after we decided to kick this off, the first person I called was Richard. I know that he would make this work, and in the space of a couple of weeks, here we are. So it took us about 3 weeks to get this organized, and what we have is the grand opening today, which is with the grilled food, but we also have groceries. And what the food bank will do on a weekly basis, at least Tuesday and Saturday to begin with, is have groceries for all of you who need the groceries to come in and pick up items for your family. We also have baby food and formula. So we want to make sure we're covering everybody in the family. This is a volunteer donation effort. We do have town government taking the lead, and that's our town council. Everyone on the town council has a job to do. Ms. Tonja Brown, who's here, is our education guru. Richard is taking care of the food bank. The vice mayor, Walter McKenzie, focuses on the broadband authority. And Dennis Price is working on the economic development and the tourism part of our agenda. So everyone has a job. We will be going out to civic organizations and the churches to see if they'll donate so that we can keep this going. And the more volunteers and donations we have, the greater the schedule. So if we can get everyone involved, our goal is to have the food bank open every day, not just a couple of times a week. But we are starting off with Tuesday and Saturday. So let your neighbors know that everyone is welcome here. And we feel that it's an important part of the community for us to help each other. So enjoy yourself. Take the food home. If you can donate something, great. If not, let your neighbors know. But enjoy yourself today, and we'll see you later. Thank you.
Thank you.
Give her a hand. All right. We appreciate everybody that's coming out today.